What have we gotten ourselves into?
Mr. and Mrs. Cerullo.
Oh, please. Just call us a Carmine and Gloria. And you are?
Reginald.
Oh, okay.
Here, let me grab that.
Oh, no. I can manage. I'm fine.
Okay. The family's waiting for you in the living room.
All right. Pops! Ma! Oh, Ma, you shouldn't have. Oh, honey, I would never come empty-handed.
Welcome to the Quartermain.
Yeah, let me introduce you. Ma, Pops, this is Paige and Emily Bowen. Guests also, so you shouldn't feel like the only one.
Oh, hello.
This is my grandmother, Lila.
Uh-huh.
My grandfather, Edward.
How do you do?
We're so glad you could come.
Piccolano and ELQ.
That's right. My pickles are really very good.
Oh, well, this is one of my specialties, a cannelloni with prosciutto. Enjoy.
Oh, how lovely. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. And this is Monica.
Dear. Got it.
And her husband, Alan.
The doctor.
Hello. Mm-hmm.
And my cousin, AJ.
Son of the aunt and the doctor.
Lois has told us all about you.
Oh, and the other brother.
No. That's the other brother is Jason. Remember? No, this is Reginald. Oh, you know Reggie? Sure, yes. Reginald Quartermain, another cousin, right?
Actually, it's just Reginald Butler.
Reginald Butler is a very nice name, too. Very distinguished.
It's Reginald the Butler.
But you're right. He's practically a member of the family.
Yes, he is, certainly. Absolutely.
Except he doesn't look like a butler.
It's the red suspenders.
Oh. Lois, dear.
Yeah.
Why don't you take your parents up to the guest bedroom? They may want to freshen up and dress for dinner. Cocktails in half an hour?
Straight gin.
Then we'll really be able to get to know each other.
Oh, boy. Come on.
What's this change for dinner stuff?
Oh, well, just...
I only brought one jacket.
Oh, just change your tie, Pops. I mean, that should take care of it, okay?
Ah, someone went in all luggage.
Well, the maid probably unpacked for you, Ma.
Oh, God. I knew I should have put silk undies in it. Oh.
Reginald, Right, you're going to tell us about the butler, Lois.
Well, I'm sorry, Pops. Okay, there's also a cook. They call a cook, and there are a couple of maids and two or three gardeners, but none of them seem to have any names.
Boy, this is something. Wow.
Mints. I hate mints.
Then don't eat them.
Boy. Wow.
This is fancy. This is fancier than the hotel room that we had on our honeymoon.
Oh, come on. Fancy smancy. Bunch of old stuff. Like living at Goodwill.
Goodwill should be so lucky. Oh, boy. You know what I feel like? I feel like I'm in one of them antique stores that we can't afford, and I'm scared stiff that I'm going to smash into a clock, and I'm going to have to pay for it. Carmine, get your feet off the bed.
This is going to be a miserable experience.
Oh, Pops, they couldn't have been any nicer just now. Admit it.
For Republicans.
What do you expect? They're from Long Island.
Yeah, with more millions than morals.
Oh. Carmine, no politics.
Yeah. Don't tell me somebody who voted for Cuomo would have treated our little girl the way Ashton did.
Oh, Pops, I don't know how he voted. And you promised to try and forgive him.
But not to forget. And don't you forget either.
Pops, the whole purpose of this visit is for our families to get acquainted. If you keep this up, it's just going to be a disaster. Don't think of him as the Qs, okay? Just think of him as plain folks.
And what do you think they're saying about us?
Thank you.
Oh, Ned, do try to relax. You remind me of a parent at a school recital. Monica, dear, I'm going to seat you across from Gloria at dinner, since Paige and Emily decided on a quiet supper in their own room. Alan, see what you can do to make Carmine at his ease. Discuss sports equipment.
Like what, croquet wickets? What's the name of his store? Guts and Glory.
AJ, that's enough. Monica, are we expecting Jason for dinner?
Unless he's lost track of time.
Well, all I have to say is that this marriage better stick. At least Catherine didn't have a family to foist off on us.
Edward, something other than your usual grumpy self would be delightful.
What a joke that is.
This is the beginning of the dinner party.
They're coming.
Something to drink?
Reginald is very handy with a cocktail shaker. He can manage just about anything.
White wine.
Batard Montrachet or Pouilly Fumé?
I recommend the Montrachet.
I'll have the same.
Got a beer?
Imported or domestic?
If it foams, I'll drink it.
Well,
it's hard to believe that spring is already here. It's a lot warmer in the city.
I'm looking forward to playing tennis outside again. Tell me, Carmine, how do you stand on the battle between aluminum and wood?
No skin off my nose either way. I don't play the game.
But what's your opinion as an entrepreneur?
I'm a storekeeper.
Pop, that's what he meant.
Small, independent business made this country great.
Yeah, that's how ELQ started.
Of course, we didn't have the hostile business environment you have to contend with.
Oh, it's really a very friendly neighborhood.
Wine?
Thank you. I was referring to the confiscatory taxes levied by New York City. How they can expect any business to survive is beyond me.
What's the matter with taxes?
Nothing, if you like giving away hard-earned money.
I see it as giving it back. City's been good to me and my family. I don't mind contributing a few extra dollars.
Contribute means that it's voluntary.
Tried out those new golf clubs?
And if those dollars went back into your pocket, then maybe you could open up another small business in your neighborhood, hire two or three people, therefore putting them on the tax roll, and at the same time generating tax income. Hmm?
The city gets their money either way, which is a good thing, because somebody's got to pay their fair share for the cops and the teachers. God knows, the rich people don't.
Lois said your dog had a puppy. Oh, yes. Yeah, we just found out. Louis and his wife, Dee Dee, are having another child. They have a little daughter named Angie, and my oldest son, Mark, and his wife, Noreen, have twin boys, Vinny and Pat, and oh boy, are they a handful.
Do you have pictures?
Yes.
You know, they're saying that the population of this country will be 500 million in 50 years.
Think of all those taxpayers.
I'm thinking of all those people who'll wind up on the dole. It takes 12 generations to double the standard of living. Something's got to be done about the immigration laws.
Why? This country was built by immigrants. It was the land of opportunity for our families. Looking around, I'd say it was for yours, too.
But times...
Very good point, Carmine.
Times have changed. We don't need bodies to work in the mines or in the factories or to lay tracks for the railroad. What we need is a skilled, computer-literate workforce.
Edward, surely you're not saying that only skilled, potentially literate computer people are born in this country.
I'm just saying there won't be enough to go around.
So now we're in the lifeboat, pull up the ladder.
You overload that boat and it will sink and we will all drown.
Why not build another boat? Of course, that means taxes that you don't want to pay.
This time of year, everybody seems to have taxes on the brain. Have you noticed?
As I see it, the only people in this country who have a right to complain about immigration are the Native Americans.
Oh, hi!
There you are.
I would like for you to meet my parents, Ma, Pop.
Wait, don't tell me. The chauffeur.
No, I'm Jason.
Dinner.
Let's. I'm dying.
If you...
Be quiet.
Well, I, for one, would just like to say that I think it was very generous of the Cerullos to allow bygones to be bygones and welcome Ned into the family. You all have my condolences.
AJ?
Ned knows I'm kidding, don't you, Ned?
Lois tells me, Carmine, that you're a musician.
A drummer.
In my youth.
Well, I'm an opera buff myself.
Oh, we love opera. Every Sunday afternoon on public radio.
Oh,
did you manage to catch Sutherland and Pavarotti and Rigoletto?
Donne mobile, qual più mal vedo, muta d'accento e di pensiero.
Oh, I wish I were Italian.
You saw La Boheme last time I was in Paris.
Paris? Oh, my.
I'm so glad the daffodils were out for your visit.
Oh, it looks like a sea of yellow up and down either side of the driveway.
You should see Mother's roses.
Oh, I do hope you'll come back when they're in bloom.
I grow tomatoes myself. We have a special deal with the live poultry shop around the corner. They give us all the fertilizer we can use. Come July, my tomatoes are as big around as your fist.
I do envy your chicken iguana.
This is tasty. Should we talk about the wedding? No, my, not right now.
So tell me, Ned.
Pops, would you like some bread over here?
How's this two-career thingy-wingy going?
Fine.
Well, I just think it's a good thing for ELQ that some of the rest of us are willing to pick up the slack for Ned.
I always felt my day job benefited from the satisfaction I got from playing in the band at night.
That's a very interesting perspective.
It's exactly how I feel, Carmine.
If you got music in your soul, you cannot try to deny it.
I'll tell you what I think.
Yes, dear?
I think I'll have another helping of this, excellent duck.
By all means, Reginald.
Thank you. Grandfather, did you hear somebody traded a Mickey Mantle rookie card for a sailboat? It was in the paper.
Well, I say whoever wound up with Mantle got the better end of the deal. Oh, those were the days. Before the free agent system ruined the game.
Couldn't agree more.
Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely.
A disgrace.
Yeah. Oh, Carmine talks about this all the time.
So does Edward.
Yeah. Of course, Reed always did wear a Yankee uniform, but the Mets are breaking my heart.
Oh, God.
The Yankees expected to pay to get the finest.
And this from a man who deplores free agency.
Now, I've heard those snide remarks about pinstripes being all wallet and no heart. You cannot win pennants without heart. You look at the record books.
Need I point out, the Mets brought home the last New York pennant.
I really missed the World Series last year.
And may I remind you that the Yankees almost prevailed in 94.
Almost only counts in horseshoes or hand grenades.
I'll ask you not to make light of hand grenades. I saw combat in World War II.
Yeah? Well, I clawed my way up Pork Chop Hill.
The Korean War.
Oh, can we discuss the wedding?
No.
Maybe tomorrow. What else is on the agenda?
Well, we thought we would give them the nickel tour, including such high spots as the Quartermain Shakespeare Garden and ELQ.
Yeah, and also the rest of the LMP family wants to meet them. Brenda, Miguel, Lily. Oh, and Mary May.
And Sonny has invited them for dinner over at Luke's.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my goodness, that's a full day. You can't possibly go back to New York tomorrow night. You'll be exhausted.
Well, hey, you know, I've got a great idea. Why don't you stay another night?
Oh, we couldn't possibly.
Oh, but you must. I insist.
Well, I guess we could manage one more night.
I hope you won't be able to sleep a wink tonight after that ungodly performance at the dinner table.
A Mets fan.
There are worse things.
A knee-jerk liberal.
Edward, he's your grandson's father-in-law.
Don't remind me. Damn it, I did everything I could, and that man twisted everything I said.
You could have said less.
I practically bit off my tongue, but he obviously came here prepared for a fight, all set to blame the lot of us for stealing his little girl. Well, I had nothing to do with it. And I resent feeling that I have to defend my way of life just because somebody's a reverse snob.
Oh, well, tomorrow is another day.
Oh, dear God, Lila.
Now, Edward, those two young people have struggled mightily for their happiness. It won't hurt you to struggle along for another 24 hours on their behalf.
Oh.
It's a hoity-toity lunatic asylum.
They're your daughter's in-laws.
She's too good for them.
You liked Monica. I mean, she knows opera, and her husband, Alan, seemed nice. I mean, the boys, I mean, especially Jason, very polite. I mean, Lila is a doll.
Which brings us to the old goat himself. Boy, if that's where Ned's headed in the next 50 years, God help Lois. I mean, how am I going to go through another day without knocking his block off?
For Lois's sake. And as a reward, maybe tomorrow night we could go out and find that hot tub Lois was talking about.
Oh, you and me in a hot tub, huh?
Do I have good ideas? Or what?
Send me to Bosnia. Send me to Haiti. Just please don't ask me to run interference between my pops and your grandfather for another 24 hours.
Grandfather respects people who stand up to him.
Oh, respectful is not how I would describe dinner. Hostile is more like it. Do we stand a chance? Our families hated each other on sight.
Not true. We just have two very strong egos who aren't used to sharing center stage. We can handle this.
How?
Well, we have all night to come up with something.
Please, God. Just let me live through tomorrow. What are you doing?